The Kearsarge football team had high expectations heading into the 2015 season, given its success from a year ago. So I headed down to Pembroke Academy on Saturday to see how the Cougars would fare in Week 1 action.
And it didn't take long for the visiting team to make a statement, as a 3-and-out on Pembroke's first drive resulted in a well-timed blocked punt by Cam Webster that was promptly scooped up by Scott Matthews and carried into the end zone for a 6-0 lead and the team's first touchdown of the season. Kearsarge added to that lead midway through the quarter on its first offensive play from scrimmage. This time it was quarterback Willie O'Rahor who got the job done, racing 45 yards to pay dirt to put his team up a commanding 12-0. The Cougars made it a 24-0 game on the first play of the second quarter when Justin Norris fielded a punt near his own sideline and then cut across the length of the field before scampering some 50 yards for his team's third touchdown of the game. And then for good measure, a 4-yard rush from Riley Antel midway through the second quarter, followed by a dominant 68-yard run from Norris behind some more solid blocking, had Kearsarge celebrating a 36-0 halftime lead. The Cougars added one final touchdown early in the fourth quarter when Parker Pitts rushed in from 11 yards out to put the visiting team up 43-0. Pembroke did have some cause to celebrate later in the quarter, though, when quarterback Julius Monroy connected with tight end Noah Manto on a 57-yard touchdown pass to round out the game's scoring. I spoke to Kearsarge coach Zach Matthews after the game, who said he was happy with the way his team battled through any pregame jitters to put up such a solid effort.
I mean, obviously really proud of the kids. We talked about coming out and getting right after them. Very pleased with the effort, obviously, our kids made. First game, jitters are always there. So you worry about your group coming out and playing to potential. And credit to our kids, they came out and took care of business. Obviously, 3-and-out in that first series, they go to punt. We get a good pressure, get a blocked punt. I think that just started to roll from there. I think kids were excited, obviously, to be out here.
The Cougars will try and make it 2 wins in a row on Saturday when they welcome Kennett to town. Taking a look at the YCN scoreboard, there was a lot more football being played over the long weekend as Lebanon, Stevens, and Newport all fought their way to hard-earned wins in Week 1, while Fall Mountain came up a little short in its first outing of the year. And over in Vermont, Hartford improved to 2-0 on the season with a narrow win over Colchester, and Springfield improved to 1-1 with an impressive bounce-back win on the road.